9 to 10 p.m. Monday night on Liffey Sounds. The world you don't know. The world you don't know. 9 to 10 p.m. Monday night on Liffey Sounds.
Now, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You're very welcome along to this week's edition of The World You Don't Know with myself, Mick O'Connell. I don't have a guest lined up tonight, but I do have quite some interesting stuff to talk about tonight. I just want to make a quick announcement. I just heard there a while ago that Gene Wilder had died. And the reason I mention that is because something I spoke about on my show before was the Mandela Effect. And there's a couple of videos that went up online in regards to the Mandela Effect where some people thought that Gene Wilder died last year. And I sort of thought he did, but I was just speaking to Dave, the guy who's on before me on the radio, and he remembers him being sick last year, and maybe that's what it was as well. So, you know, we can have sort of half memories, false memories, whatever, but I honestly thought he passed away last year, there or thereabouts. But anyway, it is official, Gene Wilder has passed away. What a great actor. Some great movies like Stir Crazy and Hear No Evil, See No Evil. Always a great double act with Richard Pryor, so he'd be missed. But, you know, a lot of people are saying celebrities, a lot of celebrities are dying lately, and there's a lot of, you know, natter in the conspiracy world about celebrities getting whacked and stuff like that. It's not that. Look, we all grew up with an awful lot of celebrities, say from the 70s up to now, and they're all getting older and older and older. They're not going to live forever, and that's why there's so many celebrities, in my opinion, dying all of a sudden in their 70s and 80s. Because they're getting old, you know, people die. That's the way the world works. But anyway, I'll leave that at that. As I said, Gene Wilder has passed away, so may he rest in peace. Great actor. Now, moving on. I seen what I can only describe, I suppose, as a disturbing post this morning. Now, we had a guy on my show, I'd say about a year ago now, Max Igan from Australia. Lovely, lovely man. One of the great truth seekers out there, very popular online. And he put a post up this morning which has, I suppose, shocked most of the truth movement who would follow the likes of Max Egan. And it's in regards to another guy who most people would consider a great truth warrior out there called Ken O'Keefe, who was an ex-military man from California, who he's, I suppose, famous in the truth movement for renouncing his American citizenship back in, I think, 2001, just after 9/11, when he realised 9/11 was a bullshit event that wasn't done by who the mainstream media told us did it, i.e. Osama bin Laden. Anyway, he accuses Israel of doing it. But Ken O'Keefe, the thing about him is he's a massive campaigner for what's going on in Gaza. He's been to Gaza. He's actually been to Gaza with Max Egan. The two of them became friends through meeting up via the troop movement, going to seminars, etc., etc. And Ken O'Keefe himself has, like Max Egan, garnered a massive, massive following online. Now, of course, you get the accusations flung about online from different blogs saying both are shills and they're inside men and they're just there to distort the troop movement and stuff like that. Now, as I said, I've interviewed Max Egan. And fair play to the man. I gave him, I think it was 3 days' notice. I'd been chasing him down for a long time. He's a very sought-after man, particularly on online radio shows. You know, you'll get him on shows 2 or 3 nights a week. He'd be doing shows. But it took me a while to track him down, and I eventually got him to come on my show, and it was a great show. You can go onto the World You Don't Know page on YouTube, and the show is up there, the Max Egan show. I'm nearly sure it's up there. If it's not, stick something on the World You Don't Know page, and I'll get it up there for you. But anyway, I did the interview with Max, and as I said, I found him to be an honest man with integrity. He didn't come across to me as any sort of a shill or a plant, if you will. So he, as I said, he put a post up this morning in relation to Ken O'Keefe. And it's a very, very serious accusation that's been made in relation to Ken O'Keefe. As I says, Ken O'Keefe had garnered a massive, massive following over the last 10 years in the troop movement with his outspoken comments on Israel, what Israel get up to in Gaza. You know, the kind of stuff he would talk about you won't get on the mainstream media, because no one in the mainstream media has the gall or the will, I suppose, to criticise Israel for what they do in Gaza. But Ken O'Keefe, people like him, Max Egan, and others do. But anyway, as I said, Ken O'Keefe wanted to start this organisation, if you will, called World Citizen Foundation. I think that's what it was called. But he was raising money. But it turns out that all along, apparently, according to Max Egan anyway, he's been a fraud. He's misappropriated hundreds and hundreds of thousands of donated money and has basically done a run out to Dominica with the money. Now, I don't know if any of this is true. As I said, Max Egan put the post up. I haven't spoken to Max. I haven't even mailed him. I'm going to wait a few days, see what transpires. As I said, I'm not going to prejudge Ken O'Keefe either. I've never spoken to the man, but what I will say is this. I did approach his people online to get him to come on my show about 7 or 8 months ago. And the response I got from them, they weren't looking for money, but what they did say to me was, how big is your show, how big is your listenership, and how big is your truth circle? Now, whatever the hell they meant by that, I mean, obviously listenership figures, but I couldn't give them any figures. I said, look, I don't know, we're a community station, I'm a volunteer at the station, I don't get paid to do the show, I produce the show myself, it's all done off the cuff, there's no pre-planning, no nothing, I just go in and I do the show. And they never got back to me. So, to me, as far as I'm concerned, and my mate Robbie, who's up and done a show with me, he even remarked to me today, he says, look, it's like this, Mick, you asked them to do the show, the response you got was that you weren't big enough for Ken O'Keefe. Your show's not big enough for Ken O'Keefe, and that's fair enough. He probably wants to get to a bigger audience. But if it did come down to money or big listenership figures, it shouldn't matter. Even if only one person who listens to my show, I don't know if anyone is even listening to this show right now. I could be just sitting in the studio talking to myself. Who knows? I don't know. But if there is anybody listening to the show, most of you can listen to what I'm saying and say, that's just bullshit, it's conspiracy theory, wacky wacky, get your tinfoil hat, whatever, I don't care. Doesn't bother me. Bought it off a duck's back. But if what I do say on my show has even the ability to affect one person and wake them up to the bullshit that's going on in this world, the scumbaggery that goes on in this world, well then I've achieved my goal. I've done what I came here to do. I've departed some information and somebody has taken it on board and they've rammed it. And that's my philosophy. You know, I don't ask for any money to do this show. I haven't got a GoFundMe page. I don't have a donation page. I don't have anything. I don't ask for any money to do this show. I just, at my own expense, drive up from my house every Monday night and I do the show. Now, it doesn't cost me much. It's fiber and petrol. I'm not complaining about the cost. That's not what I mean. But as I says, I don't make any money off this show. I've no intentions of making any money off this show. And the reason I've no intentions of making money off this show is because it's immoral, as far as I'm concerned. Now, don't get me wrong. There are truth seekers out there, like the great and wonderful Max Egan, who goes on speaking engagements around the world, and that doesn't come free. That has to be paid for. So if people want to donate money to Max Egan via thecrowhouse.com, that's fair enough. I've no truck with that. I've no argument with that whatsoever. But if it's true what he's saying, that Ken O'Keefe has raised countless thousands of dollars, euros, pounds, whatever you want to call it, and has done a run-on with the money, well, that's absolutely disgusting. But I want to give you another theory to what could be going on. Because as I said, I was talking to a friend of mine on Facebook today, Trevor. He said he'd try and listen in from Awake and Aware in Southeast Ireland. Hello, Trevor. If you are listening in, I hope you are. And if you are, fair play. Thanks very much. But I was speaking to him via Facebook earlier on, and he's going to do what I'm going to do. And that's wait and see. Wait and see what happens. I mean, Ken O'Keefe hasn't, as far as I know up to now, responded to what Max Egan put up earlier on. And if you want to see, go on to just go on to Max Egan's Facebook page or onto YouTube, and there'll be stuff up there about it. It's fresh today, so you'll be able to find it quite easily. And have a read of what he says in relation to this funding going missing. And he's basically calling Ken O'Keefe a fraud, a shill, a plant, even if you will, that he's used the troop movement and the suffering of the people of Gaza for his own financial gain. Now, if that's the case, that's a massive fraud, and he should be prosecuted for it, as far as I'm concerned. He should be done. But here's my theory. I think, this is just my opinion. This is not anything that I've seen online or anything I'm basing on fact. I'm not. This is just an opinion. It's pure conjecture. The troop movement. I mean, there's no doubt that the troop movement has been getting infiltrated for the last, since it began, I suppose, since the internet began. I mean, there has been a troop movement as long as man has existed. There's always been people out there who have tried to get the truth out about how this world really works. You know, there's been books written by some great people over the years, like Eric von Daniken, for example, writing stuff about ancient civilizations and UFOs and alien connections, and some very interesting books. David Icke's been writing books for years. And plenty of others like him. Jim Mars is another great author as well, who's wrote some interesting books about JFK and UFOs and lots of other subjects as well, particularly the New World Order. And I think what's going on now is that these people have been making such ground, to people like Max Egan, Ken O'Keefe, if he is indeed innocent. I mean, Ken O'Keefe completely criticises Israel and their actions in Gaza. You know, and I'm always reminded of a quote that I see online popping up all the time. And it goes something like this. If you want to know who it is that rules over you, try and find out who it is that you are not allowed to criticise. They're the ones that rule you. If you can't criticise them, they rule you. And one thing you never do is see the mainstream media criticising Israel, Zionism, or what's going on in Palestine. And I believe, as many other truthers out there believe, the world is screwed up and it's going to stay that way and it's going to keep going that way and it's going to get worse and worse and worse. If we, as ordinary people on the streets, stand by, sit back and do nothing about what's going on in Palestine. Don't get me wrong, we've got our own battles going on in this country. We've got our own battles. I mean, we've got the water charge situation going on. There's the homeless situation going on. There's the mortgage situation going on. You know, there's the fact that we're getting turned into a police state here as well. And people don't see it, you know. You've got all these armed guards all over Dublin now because of gangland. I mean, it's not just because of that. They want to arm the guards. And I'll tell you why they want to arm the guards. And this is just my opinion as well. Shoot me down for it if you want. I believe that the elite are running scared. The ones who cause all the problems in the world are running scared. And what they're doing is they're arming the police forces to the teeth because they know that one day it's going to be the people en masse are going to snap. They're going to snap. And they're going to stand up to this corrupt system that's going on in this world. And they're arming themselves to the teeth to make sure that they're protected. That's what all these armed police are for. You know, I find it strange in this country that you have these armed guards on the streets. And I've noticed, look, you know, if there's a gangland problem and people are running around shooting each other, there needs to be a response. I get that. But I believe there's something more sinister going on. I believe they're turning Ireland into a police state. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I do believe they're turning this country into a police state. You can just see that by the amount of armed police that are on our streets. Yes, they're saying they're there to disrupt criminal activity. That's fair enough, I get that. But yeah, you look at the uniforms, they're like combat uniforms now they're wearing. You know, whatever happened to the, you know, PC plod, if you will. You know, proper community police, and you don't see that anymore. There isn't any. You know, you don't see guards, they're too afraid to anyway, but you don't see guards walking through housing estates anymore. Very, very rarely. Very rarely you see that. And now they're getting armed to the teeth, and I don't believe it's anything to do with what they're saying it is. I believe they're getting ready to protect the elite because they know the bubble is going to burst very, very, very soon. The whole world is trillions of dollars in debt. To who? To who? And in the meantime, there's children getting slaughtered in Gaza, and all we can worry about in this country and other countries around Europe and America is the likes of the X Factor and other bullshit that's going on, or Celebrity Big Brother, another bullshit like that. And as I said a few minutes ago, until the world wakes up and says enough is enough in relation to places like Gaza, places like Syria, the world is just going to get worse, worse and worse. It's never going to stop. Really isn't going to stop. But unfortunately, that's the way the world has gone. And we've allowed it to go on like that. But now, getting back to what I was talking about a few minutes ago, Ken O'Keefe, and I know I'm jumping a little bit away from that. I believe what's actually going on here is, and I could be wrong, but maybe I'm not, I don't know. I think what's happening here is that the likes of Max Egan and Ken O'Keefe have really, really woken people up. And in order for them to disrupt, and when I say them, I mean the elite of this world, the people that control this world, in order for them to disrupt what they're doing, they need to blacken both of their names, or even one of them, and cause a rift. You know, as I said a few minutes ago, I haven't spoken to Max Egan in person, either on Skype or on the phone or any other way. I haven't spoken to Ken O'Keefe. So I don't believe any bullshit that I see getting put online or put anywhere until I hear it from the horse's mouth. End of. It's as simple as that. You know, that goes for, you know, family rifts. We all have family rifts. You know, he said, she said. Believe nothing till you hear it from the horse's mouth. Simple as that. And you'd be a fool to believe it if you see it or read it or hear it somewhere else. Get it from the horse's mouth. Get it from the source. Simple as that. So, did Max Egan put that post up? Has Max Egan been compromised and that post being put up then to completely split the troop movement? It's a possibility. I'm not saying it's true. It's a possibility. Like I said, I haven't spoken to Max. So until I come across someone who has actually spoken to him and he has confirmed that this is the case, that Ken O'Keefe is indeed a shill, a fraudster, and has been defrauding the troop movement into donating countless thousands of dollars, pounds, euros, whatever, to his organisation, to his cause, and to make that money on the blood of the innocent children of Gaza. Well, that's disgusting. To think that someone could pull the wool over so many people's eyes for the last 10 years plus and no one noticed it. Nobody noticed it. I mean, look, we're all quite adept at reading body language. You know, if someone's bullshitting you, it's usually easy enough to spot it. And I've watched countless O'Keefe videos on YouTube where his seminars, speeches, whatever. And he did not come across to me as someone who was dishonest. He came across to me as a man of passion, a man with a lot of anger about what's going on in Gaza. He called out Israel, called out 9/11, called out every bit of corruption you can think of on this planet, called it out for what it is. And yet all along he's been defrauding people. I don't know, I find it extremely difficult and hard to believe. Now, I could be wrong, maybe Max Egan is 100% right, but we'll have to wait and see. Anyway, I've got to go to some ads, and I'll be back in a couple of minutes, so if you bear with me, I'll be back in 2 minutes. Talk to you very soon.
Broadcasting to Lucan, this is Liffey Sound, 96.4 FM.
Now, folks, you're very welcome back. Just before the break there, as I said, I was talking about the post that Max Egan had put up on his Facebook page and on his website this morning in regards to Ken O'Keefe. As I said, I'd like to wait and get more information over the next few days to see how this pans out. As I said, there's no reason in the world to believe that any of it's true until, I suppose, Ken O'Keefe replies. And then you can work it out for yourself then, and I don't know. It's a shame though if it is true, it really is a shame, because these are two great men who have done absolutely what can only be perceived as wonderful work for the truth movement, for and especially for the people of Palestine and Gaza. You know, what's going on out in Palestine, as I said before the break, nothing is going to get sorted out in this world until everybody wakes up and realises what's going on in Palestine has to bloody stop. People need to stand up and criticise those who are doing it. But until that happens, as I said, the world is just going to keep going on the way it is. It's going to keep getting worse. Now, moving on, I want to talk a little bit about the Mandela Effect. It's something I spoke about before on the show. I'm not going to harp on too much. But as I said at the top of the hour there, I just got a text there that Jim Oyler had unfortunately passed away. Great actor, absolutely fantastic actor. And the reason my partner sent me the text was because of the Mandela Effect. She knows that. From I was looking at the Mandela Effect, it's something I've explained to you before. I'll give you a quick explanation again. It's basically to do with parallel universes. People think there are certain people out there who believe that their version of history is different to someone else's, so to speak. Like, for example, the JFK assassination is one of the things that's caught up in the Mandela Effect, where the four people in the car were the six. Some people remember four, some remember six. And there's a lot of talk that it's something to do with parallel universes mismatching into each other, you know, about that crisscrossing or whatever. I know I'm not saying that's true, but one thing that cropped up in the Mandela Effect when I was watching a video or two a few weeks back was Gene Wilder had passed away. And I said to myself at the time when I was saying it, yeah, I remember him passing away last year. And I don't know why I remember him, I just, it felt familiar, like sort of deja vu, if you will. And then tonight, as I said, I get a text from my partner saying that indeed Gene Wilder has passed away today, officially. He's passed away, 83 years of age, I think he is. So, you know, as I said, with the Mandela Effect, there's some people actually remember him dying last year. I thought he may have died last year. And as I said earlier, I talked to Dave, the guy who was on before me in the studio, and he says, yeah, I remember him sort of being sick last year. And I said, well, maybe that's where I remembered him. You know, you read a news article, you see an article somewhere, it pops into your head, pops back out of your head. But I sort of remembered him last year. Passing away, but I could be wrong, but because he's officially passed away today, which is sad, you know. He's a great actor, but look up the Mandela Effect. It's an interesting concept. I don't know whether the Mandela Effect is true or not, but here's another couple of interesting things that I discovered. Now, I don't know if it's, you know, the people who control the internet are just taking the piss basically and having a laugh, trying to muddy the waters of the truth movement, not to mention what I was talking about there for the first few minutes of the show, Ken O'Keefe and Max Egan and the big situation going on there. But the Mandela Effect, it's having a bit like the flat earth stuff that came out there last year. There was a lot of talk about the earth being flat. I don't know if it's flat or not, to be honest with you. I don't know. I mean, the only information I get about the earth being flat is from NASA, you know, from officialdom. And we all know how trustworthy officialdom is, you know. NASA, never a straight answer. But the only way you're going to know if the world is flat or a globe is by getting yourself a rocket and going out into space and doing a U-turn and having to look back down. Then you'll know. But until then, you've only got NASA's word for it that it's not flat, that it's a globe. And that's all very cool. I don't give a toss whether it's a globe or flat. It's still a kip. You know, the world is a nut. It's a lunatic asylum. Whether it's on a flat plane or a globe, it's still a lunatic asylum. It's not going to change any difference for you, me, and the ordinary man on the street. It's always going to be the same. A nut house. But as I said, I said on my show before, now I interviewed a guy about Flat Earth maybe a year ago now, Mark Sargent from the United States. Very nice guy. He put up a very good argument for the Earth being flat. Basically saying that, you know, your perception tells you that it's flat and all that. But, you know, I gave him the airtime. I've never actually got anybody on who's adamant that it's a globe. Maybe I'll try and get Neil deGrasse Tyson on. He's NASA's front man for science. You always see him on the telly with Michio Kaku and whatnot, you know. He's a globe man. He says it's a globe. So if he says it's a globe, it must be a globe. But he's part of the mainstream media. But I can't help thinking that all that flat earth stuff was put out there last year, as I said, to divide and conquer the truth movement, because for governments around the world, via the internet, the truth movement is getting too big for its boots. Too much information coming out with the likes of Edward Snowden and Julian Assange and other whistleblowers. They don't want all this stuff going out. I mean, even that, I seen a post there by that girl that made the documentary about Mary Boyle, the young girl about missing in Donegal. There's a lot of political collusion involved and stuff like that, and very murky stuff. But she said she's getting harassed now by the state. But it wouldn't surprise me, you know, the state will do anything to protect their interests. But this is the world we live in, folks. But as I said, that the flat earth stuff, I believe, was put out there to divide the truth movement. And I think the Mandela effect, although the thing about the Mandela effect is it's that little bit more spookier, you know, because it does get you asking questions about your own memories. That's the worst thing about it. But as I said, Jim Wilder, I sort of remember him passing away last year. Maybe I could be wrong. Maybe I seen a news article saying that he wasn't very well last year. And he's passed away now this year, which would be, you know, conducive to anyone who's grown old. That tends to be the end result of when you grow old, is that you pass away. Anyway, if you have any texts you want to send in, you can do 087-062-7138. That's 087-062-7138. If you have any thoughts on the Mandela Effect or the Flat Earth, or if you're aware in any way, shape or form about this thing with Ken O'Keefe. And if you are, you know, I'd like your opinion. It'd be great to get your opinion on it. But we leave that at that anyway. Moving on, a few other things that I want to talk about on the show tonight as well. As I said, I'm just rabbiting on here tonight. Syria. Now, I've been watching quite a lot of the news lately in relation to what's going on in Syria. And I've said this before on the show, I have a firm belief that they're going to do their best to kick off, I'm not going to say World War III, but a conflict, nevertheless, and use Syria as an excuse. You've got the Chinese entering the fray now. You've got the Turks entering the fray. They've just sent in a lot of tanks to take on ISIS. Now, I was talking about Turkey here a few weeks ago with the attempted kill and stuff like that, saying that Erdogan, from what I can gather anyway, is a New World Order puppet. You know, he works with the financial elite. That coup, I believe, and I said it before in the show, I believe that coup in Syria, in Turkey, was instigated by Erdogan and his own people, maybe with the help of the CIA, Mossad even, because there were, I'm not going to say, they wouldn't be moderates, I mean, moderates wouldn't want to go to war with anybody, but hardliners, if you will, who wanted Turkey to enter the fray, including Erdogan himself, who wanted to enter the fray in Syria, but were being denied the ability or the permission to go into Syria by more moderate politicians throughout Turkey, who said, no, this is the wrong way to go. You know, we want to become members of the European Union, blah, 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 blah. We're not going into Syria. We're having nothing to do with that conflict. Even if they do keep firing the odd missile into our country, we're not going to respond with tanks or with troops on the ground. But now they have. And I can't help thinking that coup in Turkey was to get rid of any opposition whatsoever to Erdogan. Because if you look now, there's been literally thousands upon thousands of opponents of Erdogan and Erdogan's regime rounded up and locked up without trial, without due cause, without nothing. They're getting rid of the opposition. That's what they're doing. Now, whether they can do that here, don't put it past them. There's nothing I wouldn't put past any state. But now, within weeks of Erdogan clinging on to power, not that he even clinged on, holding on to power, through what I believe was an engineered coup, engineered by himself, to make it look like the people were trying to take over the country, and then he'd done a clean sweep of all his opposition and got rid of them all in one go. I don't know if it's true or not, but it looks that way. Listen, I'm going to go to a quick break. I've actually got Max Higan, who's actually replied to me, and it'd be great to get him on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a song for you and see, can I get him on? Just give me a second, I'll go to my folder and I get myself a song out. I don't know what I'm going to play, but let me see. Where's all my songs? Oh, here they are. Now, let me see. Oh, yeah, here's a good song to play. This will be a good song. I'm going to play this song right now, so have a listen to this, and I'll be back to you in a couple of minutes. I'm just going to have a quick chat with Max. Talk to you in a second.
Listening to Liffey Sound, www.liffeysoundfm.ie. Listen online. Community radio at its best.
Now, folks, you're very welcome back. I was talking to Max then, as I said. He's not going to come on now. He's actually over in South America. He's in the Amazon at the moment. He hasn't got a very good signal. But he did say that his head's a bit all over the place. And quite understandably so, folks, because... You know, he put that post up on his Facebook page this morning with a very heavy heart, as he said in his post. And I wouldn't like to put him under any pressure whatsoever to reply to the post. I mean, he put the post up. Ken O'Keefe has his own time to reply to the post, I suppose. And we'll know more about what's going on then. And unfortunately, it's a bit of a blow, as opposed to the truth movement, that this has transpired, that it turns out Ken O'Keefe may indeed be a fraud. I don't know if he is. But we'll know more in the future. But as I said, I've just spoken to Max there now on Skype. He's been kind enough to message me back. And it is Max's channel. I mean, I spoke to him before on this same channel. As I said, his head's all over the place. You know, he's been going through a bit of a difficult time, I suppose. You know, when you've, you know, believed in someone and their work for so long, and all of a sudden have it sort of blow up in your face. It can't be an easy pill to swallow. So just heads up, Max, if you're listening, and I hope everything works out for the better anyway. You know, this is, as I said, been a terrible blow for the truth movement. But I mean, that's the nature of things, folks. You know, unfortunately, the truth movement is not just full of truthers. That's the problem. There's a lot of shills out there. There's a lot of dark people who are doing their level best to completely stifle the truth movement because it's gaining such bloody ground. That's the problem for the elite, for the authorities, for the state. People are waking up to that bullshit. And, you know, unfortunately, Max, and he's a lovely bloke. I've never met him in person. I've spoken to him on my show. I've had him on for an hour, as I said before. I know people who've met him. I've met people who've met Max. And, you know, they've nothing but good things to say about him. As I said, he never asked me for money to come on my show. He'd done the hour show. He was kind enough to get out of his bed at 5 o'clock in the morning, Australian time, and do my show. And, you know, for someone to do that, that says it says a lot about their integrity, that they're willing to talk to a Joe Soap like me, who, you know, let's face it, has no business being on radio, you know. And I haven't. I'm not the kind of person you see on FM 104 or something like that, you know. People want that. That's the kind of radio people want. That's what they get. That's not my style. I'm just here to, you know, divulge information that I come across. Because if I come across something that upsets me and it pisses me off, I have the right, I believe people have the right to know about it. And that's why I do the show, to get the information out there. You know, it's like a friend of mine on Facebook, Trevor Ivers, and he is listening in. He did send me a comment on Facebook, and he is listening. So thanks for listening, Trevor. Spread the show. That's the great thing about people like you. I follow Trevor, as I said, on Facebook, and you know, he's no different to people like Max as well. His heart is in the right place, he's doing great things, but he puts up with a lot of bullshit on people who he would have seen as friends, family, stuff like that. And you know, they look at him as though he's got two heads because he's trying to get the truth out. And as I always said, and I'll always say this, you know, even if the truth is in a minority of one, the truth is still the truth. And that's not my quote. I think it was Einstein, somebody famous bloody said it years ago, but anyway, it's true. Or Gandhi, I think it might have been, that said it. But, you know, people like Trevor are doing the same thing. He set up a great page, you know, Awaken Aware in the Southeast, down in Waterford, Wexford region. And it's grown exponentially. He's got a lot of people interested in what he's doing. And he puts posts up because he gets frustrated. You know, I'd like to tell you, I've been at this for a long, long time, you know, 15 years plus. And it is frustrating. We've lost a lot of friends over the years, family as well, people who don't talk to you anymore. And to be honest with you, and I'm going to tell it to you straight, I couldn't give a rat's. Simple as that. I'm not here to impress anybody. If people don't want to have anything to do with me because of my beliefs, thinking I'm a wacky conspiracy theorist who should be wearing a tinfoil hat or locked up in a padded cell, believe what you want. You go home, watch The X Factor, watch EastEnders, do whatever the bloody hell it is you do. Do you know what I mean? If you don't like what I do, don't look at what I do. Simple as that. And that's the advice I give to people like Trevor. If you don't like what they're doing, don't be looking at what they're doing. Move on. There's plenty of other bullshit on the internet to get your head into. Go asleep and look at that. But people like Trevor, you know, history will look at people like him as those who didn't stand by idly while the world was bloody falling apart and getting sucked into the abyss by these rich globalist banking elites who are sucking this planet dry and killing people off. I mean, look what's going on in Africa and all, you know. I'm going to start ranting here now in a second. But look what goes on in places like Africa and all. You know, one of the richest continents on the planet, and the people are starving to death. Why? Because massive corporations are in there robbing all the resources and stripping the countries bare. This is what they're doing. They're strip mining the whole planet. And no one cares. No one gives a damn. People like Max Igan, he gives a damn. He's out there campaigning week in, week out, day in, day out. Doesn't have to do it. He shouldn't have to do it, but he does it. You know, and then to say, this is piss me off no end. To think that post that he put up this morning could be true. It's very, very disheartening, you know, but alas, I think the truth movement should learn from it and move on from it. And what needs to be taken out of the equation in relation to the truth movement is money. You know, if someone is setting up massive GoFundMe pages to fund one project or another, you know, I'd stay clear of it, to be honest with you, you know. I really would stay clear of it. Now, some people are saying, oh, well, Max Egan must be a shill, and, you know, if Ken O'Keefe is a shill and a thing, you know, they get onto mainstream media channels like Press TV and Reuters TV and stuff like that. You know, if they were real truthers, they wouldn't have gone on those shows. Well, that's bullshit, and I'll tell you why it's bullshit. Just say, for example, and this is just my opinion again, a theory, just say, for example, Ken O'Keefe is what Max Egan has claimed him to be today, and he is a shill, and he is a fraud, and he was defrauding the children of Gaza and people around the world who are donating money to his cause to help the people of Gaza and to set up this world citizen movement. Say for argument's sake, he is a shill. And then you look at Max Egan, who has been on Press TV, and people say, well, he must be a shill too. Well, no. And I'll tell you why. They have to put people like Max on to make it look good. And if Ken is what he says it is, it needs to make him look good too. Get him alongside Max Egan. Everyone who loves Max Egan, I love Ken O'Keefe too. You can see it playing out like that. If you take a step back and have a look in, you can see how these feckers will play that game. That's how they do it. You know, Joseph Stalin himself said, if you're going to have an opposition, you better damn well control it. So they create the opposition. It's their opposition. They can control it. It works in every country. It's no different. Doesn't matter where you are. It works in every single country. You want opposition, you better damn well control it. Because can you imagine? Can you imagine, say, in this country, for example, that we got a serious, serious opposition to the bullshit politicians that we have operating in this country? They wouldn't know what to do. They wouldn't have a clue if they knew nothing about the organisation, knew nothing about the people in it, and knew very little about them even. They'd be scared because they would know then that they can't be infiltrated, they can't be subverted, and one day they're going to take over and their game is up. So what do? They create all these other little pseudo-political parties who look like they're fighting for the common man, but they're not. And it's the same with Ken O'Keefe if all that is true. Stick him out there, build him up over 10 years, you know, the angry ex-Marine. You know, I can see something like that playing out. You could see something like that even in a movie. You know, look at the movie Wag the Dog, very similar premise. You know, fool the people, let them think there's a war going on when there isn't. You know, let them think the bogeyman is really the good guy. It's not that hard to do. But this is how they do it, and this is how they're going to divide the whole troop movement. Troop movement, in my opinion, I'm not saying it's finished, but this is a very, very serious blow to it. You know, it's a very serious blow that someone with such a high standing amongst truthers around the world can turn out to be a fraud. I hope it's not true. I really hope it's not true. But sure, we'll see. Time will tell. But this is what they're doing. This is how they divide and conquer. It's the only way to rule the world is to divide and conquer. You know, unfortunately, that's the way things are. You know, the elite are running this world, but they know, and I think they're running scared. This is why they're building all these underground bunkers around the world. They've got these bunkers. I mean, even on the Denver airport, they've got these bunkers. And I think something is coming down the line. I don't know what. Now, I spoke last week on my show. I was talking to Alan from OAM. Good evening, all of you listening in. And we were talking about this new law, or this act that was passed in Germany last week, basically ordering German citizens to stockpile enough food and enough clean water, drinkable water, for 10 to 15 days in case of an impending disaster or an event that would cause shops to shut down and food not to be distributed and stuff like that. You know, a disaster, if you will. Now, here's the downside to all of that, I suppose. Czechoslovakia doesn't exist anymore, Mick. The Czech Republic, I think it is, have issued a similar order to their people to stockpile up on food to do them for 10 to 15 days. Now, I'd like to know what the bloody hell are they expecting. Now, we've had a massive earthquake in Italy there during the week. 200 plus dead, probably more. And the conspiracy theorists are out again online saying, oh, it's CERN. CERN are ramping up the Large Hadron Collider in Geneva just on the Swiss Franco border not so long ago and in around the same time as that earthquake, and that earthquake has been caused by that. I don't know. Has it been caused by that? I don't know. But there was apparently tremors even felt here in Ireland from that earthquake. But I'm not saying have I had anything to do with the earthquake. I don't know. But as I said, this talk that they did. Now, something I spoke about on my show many, many times before, and I'm not moving on from what I've just talked about and sort of going to elaborate, was the depopulation agenda. Now, if there is a depopulation agenda, there's many ways that they could achieve that. You know, they could poison us in the air with chemtrails, which they are doing. I mean, they were very bad today, though, I have to say. I was out watching there today and there was chemtrails everywhere. I mean, a lot of chemtrails. But and it's, you know, it's every time there's a bit of bloody sunny weather. We're going to supposed to have sunny weather for the rest of this week, and then the chemtrails are out. So keep your eyes up on the sky. There's a lot of chemtrailing going on. That's one way that they can depopulate, I suppose, is by poisonous from the air, then poisonous in the food, fluoride in the water, the numbers down. So, as I'm saying, if there is a depopulation agenda, war is another good way of depopulating countries. Earthquakes. Now, there's been reports since the 1950s about governments developing machines. Even Nikola Tesla apparently had the ability to create a machine that could cause earthquakes. This is over 100 years ago. So if they have, I mean, an earthquake can be caused by broadcasting deep into the earth frequencies that would upset the atomic structure, if you will, of the crust and cause an earthquake. I'm not saying it has happened, but it could happen. But if there is a depopulation agenda, folks, And then you have Germany telling their citizens to stockpile food for 10 to 15 days. The Czech Republic doing the same. Maybe there's other governments around Europe have started to do the same. I don't know. They haven't done it here. I mean, the Irish government will be the last to bloody do that anyway. They'll forget. You know, they'll be all down the pub. But not paying the bar bills. That's Irish politicians, right? They never pay their bar bills. But if there is a depopulation agenda, folks, with them talking about disasters and people needing to prep for something, is something big coming down the line that they know is going to happen and they're not going to tell anyone about? I don't know. But as Al always says on Open Your Mind Radio, you should stock up on some sort of food. You know, even if it's only a couple of weeks' worth of stuff. Because if anything did happen, it's better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. That's the thing. Now, Ray sent me in a text. Good evening, Ray. Thanks for listening in. One of them has thrown one hell of a hand grenade amongst the pigeons. You know, I'm sure he's referring to Ken O'Keefe and Max Egan. Now, as I said, I contacted Max a few minutes ago on via Skype, and he did type back to him. He didn't want to come on. And that's understandable. He's under no pressure to come onto the show. Read into that what you will. But I haven't seen a reply from Ken O'Keefe to what Max has said. Now, if there is one up there, please enlighten me, people, because I haven't seen it. But if there is a reply, I don't know. Now, Richie Allen, who has a great show over in the UK, the Richie Allen Show, now, he did put a post up today about it. I don't know if he's mentioned it on his show tonight, but he did put a post, a video, I think, or someone posted a video on his page, which apparently, and I looked at the video, it's 43 seconds long, apparently shows Ken O'Keefe in it looks like a Jeep with some girl in the passenger seat looking all sexy on camera, driving through what looks like a paradise island, probably Dominica, where Max alleges he's gone with all this money. The video has no audio, or at least the one I looked at had no audio. Now, I don't, you can make it that what you will. I don't know if there's anything going on, but it's a strange video to look at. It doesn't mean anything, to be honest with you. There's no audio in this video. You just see this guy, Ken O'Keefe, driving through, like down a dirt track or something, a country road, having a great laugh with this girl that was in the passenger seat, videoing herself, lying across the seat, looking all sexy, as I said. Is it him, two fingers up to the troop movement, saying, oh, you're a bunch of suckers, I've just taken this for several hundred thousand, and now I'm rich, and bye-bye, and I'm living in Dominica, who have no extradition treaties with any other place on the planet, and I'm home free, bye-bye. That's what it looks like. You know, I think that's what people are trying to make it look like. But as I said earlier on, and as Ray Moore has just said there, one of them has thrown one hell of a hand grenade amongst the pigeons. Someone has thrown one hell of a hand grenade amongst the pigeons. Now, I could also be conspiratorial minded and turn around and say, well, the reason Max Egan doesn't want to come on my show is because it wasn't Max Egan I was talking to. It's someone who has control of his page. Just a theory, just a thought. But if it was him, he could come on. I'd know if it's him or not, because I know what he sounds like. But I'm just being funny here now. But, I hope this resolves itself, and I hope none of it's true. And I just, that theory I come up with earlier on, that, you know, both of them could be compromised, and somebody else is pulling out these strings. I could have been talking to maybe someone in the NSA. Who knows? You wouldn't know. But, you know, we live in a strange world, folks. We really live in a strange world. Anyway, I'm going to go to a song. Because I can, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to go to a quick song, give us a look. Yeah, this might sound appropriate, considering everything that's going on. So here's a song for you. This is a fella called Chris Rea. Enjoy. Talk to you in a minute. Now, folks, you're very welcome back. And that was Chris Rea, absolutely fantastic. Great guitar solo in that song. Big fan of Chris Rea. I love him on The Road to Hell. Well, not on The Road to Hell, folks, only if you want to be. Maybe in some other reality they're on The Road to Hell. Getting back to the Mandela Effect. Trevor mentioned a comment, Trevor Ivers. And thanks for listening, Trevor. I really appreciate it every time I get a new listener. Said he's going to listen in from now on. Said it was a great show. Thank you very much. It's always nice to get a compliment. Talking about the Mandela Effect, you should look into the Mandela Effect. It's a bit of a weird phenomenon. If you type Mandela Effect, funnily enough, into Google Maps, it brings you directly to the apex of the pyramids, which is a bit of a strange place. Also, if you type in the speed of light into Google Maps, it brings you to the pyramids as well. Pretty strange that too. But if you type in the Mandela Effect into Wikipedia, you get a very strange result. It brings you to a page about a mental disorder, and I have it, I must do, called confabulation. No, I'd never heard that word. Confabulation, great word. But basically what confabulation is a mental disorder where people who have it display fake memories. And this is what the Mandela Effect is about. People have false memories, or they remember the past differently to what it says in books and stuff like that. Now, for example, when I spoke about this briefly last week, I'll give you one example of the Mandela Effect. The TV program Sex in the City. Now, I remember, this is just me, I remember that as Sex in the City. But if you go onto YouTube and Google it, Sex and the City, and always has been, there's never been Sex in the City. I said, well, fair enough, you know, I don't know why I remember that Sex in, but I didn't even watch it, I've never seen an episode of it, nor have I any intentions. But I was in Cork recently, and the house I was staying in, the lady of the house, my partner's Aunt Margaret, she's a bottle of perfume called Sex in the City, which I found a bit strange. And everything online is changing, but in the physical world is it changing. But look at Trevor, if you're going to be looking into the Mandela Effect, don't get too deep into it. Don't believe that you're seeing the Mandela Effect. I think it's a massive psyop. It's a very good one though, but I'll say that. But anyway folks, I have come to the end of the show. This has been The World You Don't Know. So I'd like to say thanks to everybody that's listened, especially Trevor and Raymore over in the UK, who never fails to listen. Thanks, Ray. Thanks for the nice comments about the show as well, Trevor. I really appreciate that. And you keep up the good work. Your page is growing exponentially. It's going from strength to strength. And as I always say, don't give a toss about what anybody thinks of you. The moment you worry about what other people are thinking, they're living your life for you. It's your life. You do it what you want. You do it your way. End of. Now, folks, as it says, I have come to the end of the show. And as I always say, the world is full of wonderful people. And if you can't find one, be one. Until next week, take care. Talk to you all very soon.
To 10 p.m. Monday night on Liffey Sounds. The World You Don't Know. The World You Don't Know. 9 to 10 p.m. Monday night on Liffey Sounds.